Hello, this is Nicholson 1968. Hope you're doing well. This is a re-release. I re-edited it so that hopefully it'll stay up. But I wanted to show you something. What you're looking on the screen here is I released this a couple of years ago. Freemasons, Fallen Angels, Lies Coming Undone, Fifth Age Countdown. And as you can see here, it says video blocked worldwide. It's blocked, cannot be played. Here's the kicker. What's really blocking is the Grammys blocked part of it, and it is part of the Lady Gaga section on the tribute to David Bowie and the technology they used. What's funny about that, and you need to ask yourself, you can go all over YouTube right now and you can see a video on Lady Gaga and David Bowie tribute. I mean, there's tons and thousands of videos out there with Lady Gaga and the David Bowie, but they chose to block mine. Why? Because I tell you why. There's something in my video they don't want you to see. So I'm re-releasing it, hope it'll stay up. I'm gonna put it on my website and host it there directly, even if YouTube takes it down.
Something's happened to that man in there. You better check in on him, sir. He won't answer me or nothing.
Please continue, go on, please.
You accept all the responsibility?
The responsibility is mine, correct. Please go on.
Gold, dollar, necklace, moon, paint. Answer, please. Are you all right? 405 volts. The answer is moon.
Whether the learner likes it or not,
But he might be dead in there.
We must continue. Go on, please.
You're going to keep giving what, 450 volts every shot now?
That's correct. Continue. The next word is white.
White. Cloud. Horse. Rock. House. Answer, please. The answer is horse, 450 volts. Next word, sad, face, music, clown, girl. The answer is face, 450 volts.
The results, as I observe them in the laboratory, are disturbing. They raise the possibility that human nature cannot be counted on to insulate men from brutality and inhumane treatment at the direction of malevolent authority. A substantial proportion of people do what they are told to do, irrespective of the content of the act and without limitations of conscience, so long as they perceive that the command comes from a legitimate authority. If in this study, an anonymous experimenter could successfully command adults to subdue a 50-year-old man and force on him painful electric shocks against his protests, one can only wonder what government, with its vastly greater authority and prestige, can command.
Hey guys, this is Nicholson 1968. Welcome to my new project. I'll try to accomplish a couple of things with this video. As always, show you some hidden things that are right in front of us, that if you look deeper, the deeper meanings behind it, what is being put forth right in front of us has a deeper meaning. I'm going to touch on MKUltra, mind control programs. I know most of you are familiar with it, and this video will connect some dots. For you out there that don't believe in MKUltra mind control programs, that think it was decommissioned, this video will be for you to show you some things, connect some dots. It's very alive and well. Fashion industry, music industry. It is one tiny piece of a bigger agenda, and the bigger agenda with an end goal. And to the normal viewer, normal person on the street, it appears to be one thing. But as you know, anybody who's followed me on this channel, is when you get behind some of these names, faces, dig deeper, the agenda becomes very clear to you. And I'm going to start with, on this video, we're going to go to Versace. And Gianni Versace began this company in 1978. They're one of the leaders in the fashion industry, been known for years. in the fashion industry, and also very connected to the music industry as well. And you'll see the connections as we go through this video and some other things. So, like I said, the normal person will see Versace, oh, he just makes clothes and da-da-da-da-da. But we're going to break it down a little bit here. I'm going to connect some dots for you. I've got some videos after this. I'm going to break it down to you. And even Versace in the commercial tell you what they're up to. They tell you in their language. And that's the thing of what I do here is they have a language all their own. The elites, the people of certain industries, mystery schools of old, these some of these families that date back, they're taught these things. Part of the language that they speak, symbols, numbers, the occult backwards, things like that. But first thing we're going to look at is the Versace logo that was taken is the actual logo, the head of Medusa. Yeah, so, you know, when asked why he chose Medusa, Gianni, he responded that, you know, he liked the logo because she made people fall in love with her and that they had no way back. I mean, that's his actual quote. Now, for you who do not know who Medusa is, Medusa was found in Roman and Greek mythology. She was a monster, generally described as a winged human female with, you know, like a hideous face, like living venomous snakes in the place of her hair. The legend goes is people who stared into her face would turn into stone. So that is the legend of Medusa. And Medusa is used a lot of different ways and symbolism throughout cultures and things like that. But one of the modern uses of Medusa, it sometimes appears and represents a notion of nihilisticism or nihilism, N-I-H-I-L-I-S-M. So let me give you some definitions of what that means. And so you'll start connecting what is really more deeply behind the symbolism of this logo. Nihilism is basically, which argues that life is without meaning, purpose, or value. That morality does not exist, and that any established moral values are abstractly contrived. So you start looking at it that way, of why they do what they do. And here's another one. Moral nihilism is actually the, for example, a moral nihilist would say that killing someone for whatever reason is not inherently right or wrong. So there's no objective, no reality. The morality does not exist. It's something inherent. You know, that is the description behind the whole thing with part of this Medusa logo and what they believe. Then now, notice that Versace and their family go back to ancient Rome, the family, and where the logo came from was when he was playing on the floor in the ruins in Rome. The siblings played as children. This is where they saw this logo back in the ancient, some ruins they were playing. This is per their words. So, it's interesting to note that in prophecy, in the Christian prophecy, that the New World Order will be, toward the end, prophecy, end times, a risen Holy Roman Empire. So, it's very interesting when you start looking back to the connections of this logo. It goes around the Medusa head, is totally Roman. That print goes back to that. And as you do your research into the Holy Roman Empire, the largest territory of that empire after 962 was the Kingdom of Germany. It's interesting that it also included the Kingdom of Bohemia, which you conspiracy people out there know of Bohemia Grove. See, nothing has really changed. Just things have been renamed, and things are still going on, renamed under different things like Bilderberg. You look at the old Holy Roman Empire Imperial Banner, it has the double eagle, or phoenix, whatever you want to say. The coat of arms, same thing. Same thing as the New World Order, their logos and their things throughout the years and secret societies, the Freemasons. It's all the same, just repackaged. So the other part of this is where I was going with this too, is in the fashion industry and the music industry, for you guys that do not believe in MK Ultra, you know, Program Monarch, things that the mind control programs out there that you think don't exist. I know most of my followers and subs are smart enough on my channel. They know quite well that it is in effect today. It's still going on a different level with AI, for artificial intelligence. That's a whole nother subject. But when you go back, like I said, Holy Roman Empire, Germany, Nazism, the scientists that were back in that day practicing on human beings, the mind controls, the MK Ultra, it still exists today. And with this commercial, I'm going to play a quick commercial, and I'm going to break it down with this commercial. Some of you have seen it, but I'm going to play it for those that are new to my channel. They're telling you without a doubt in their own commercial. And like I said, most people that are not awake, they'll just see it as a wow, this is a cute commercial kind of thing. But they're telling you with their commercials, their language. I'll play this, and then we'll come back. And I'm going to connect some more dots for you to the music industry, Nicki Minaj, things within the titles of their CDs. This is what they believe. A risen Roman, Holy Roman Empire again, part of the beast system. And so anyway, enjoy this and I'll be right back. So there you go, guys. It's pretty cut and dry once you decode it and look at it from a different perspective. You really see what's going on. I'm gonna connect a dot here for you guys. So I'm gonna play a video that is a news report that is played to the millions, and as usual, nobody knows. The cops don't have a motive, all this stuff. It involves Christina Grimmie, Orlando killing in this year in June 2016, and I'm gonna play the clip, but I want you to see how it's portrayed to the masses. But I'm gonna break it down for you. If you know the agenda and you know who's behind everything and what they're trying to accomplish, you start understanding MK Ultra, mind control, sleepers, things like that are among us now. Whether you want to believe that or not,
A 27-year-old man from Florida has been identified as the gunman who shot and killed the voice singer Christina Grimmie during a meet and greet at a show in Orlando. That according to police. His motive is still unclear. Police said Loibel does not live in Orlando and traveled to Friday night's event with the apparent intent to kill the 22-year-old singer. Loibel was armed with two loaded handguns and had additional ammunition as well as a hunting knife. Only few details have been released about the possible motive for the shooting, but police believe that Loibel and Grimmie did not know each other. Detectives are currently looking at Loibel's phone and computer in search of evidence that might point towards a motive. The singer was killed on late Friday night when Loibel approached her inside the Plaza Live in Orlando and opened fire. Authorities say Grimmie's brother Mark tackled the suspect to the ground, after which he shot and killed himself. A police statement released on Saturday afternoon said, quote, "Her brother Marcus is a hero and possibly saved countless other lives."
As you see the name of the killer, Kevin Loibel, look at the name. Loibel is a German name. And matter of fact, it's Bavarian, from Bavaria, Germany. Does that ring a bell for you guys out there? Illuminati came out of Bavaria, Germany. That's their starting point. If you go deeper into the name, it is from a pet form of the personal name Leopold, L-E-O-P-O-L-D. So if you go back to, here we go, Holy Roman Empire, the coat of arms, of the Holy Roman Emperor, Leopold II, and also Francis II. Are you making any connection here? They're telling you they leave a signature, just like you've seen in movies. They leave a signature. When they kill somebody, they either leave a rose, it's the rose killer, or they put an X on the chest of a body that they've killed, and it lets you know who the killers are, or mark, you know. This is what it is, without leaving too much evidence. This is a message for the other elites to know this is part of their agenda. So when they pick a name and people to do MK Ultra and activate them, you can believe in that or not, but I'm telling you, it is very real. It is to the next level. It is going to be using, I said it before, back in February, cell phones and technology and tones and frequencies. There's more to that, to activate these sleeper cells that are among us all over the world that have been MK Ultra programmed, monarch, mind controlled. And it sounds science fiction, but it is true, and I told you that. So let me just tell you, we're going to dive into the movie Cell. And the movie Cell has to do with cell phones and a controlling a population through a, guess what, a pulse. Orlando Pulse, the name of the frequency throughout the movie that is controlling people in this thriller movie is called the Pulse. Okay? It was released on demand. June 10th, 2016. June 10th, the day that Christina Grimmie was shot and killed. You think that's by accident? The theater date of release is July 8th, but it was released on demand June 10th. The Cell, the Pulse. Things that I'm telling you guys and other people are telling you, not just me. See, this is what this video is about, is mind control, MK Ultra, Monarch programs, things that were used a long time ago are being resurrected. Not just the old Nazi party with the shock and awe, the old timey mind control from the SS. No, this is a whole new level here of things being done through electronic pulses. That is the key word here, pulse. You've seen people put videos out, the year of the pulses, and it's exactly what I've been saying, is MK Ultra and Monarch, that's a whole nother subject, and controlled that way to activate assassins and to do certain things. But go to the next level of what I am sharing is when you figure out what is the temple of God, what is holy, what is going to be put, is trying to be put into us through chemtrails, metal particles, nanobots, nanoparticles into our body. We are part water. We are electronic beings, whether you know that or not. So the electronic pulses they've tried to figure out to control us, that is what is coming. Electronic pulse. Here's a little commercial from Beyonce telling you, giving you a heads up, this is how pre-programming works. And here it is real quick, and then we'll get back to the video.
Feel the power.
Pulse, the electric new fragrance by Beyonce.
MK Ultra, the Black Awakening, out there, the satanic super soldiers that have been MK Ultra Monarch controlled, that live among us now. And you can say I'm fear mongering, or it's fear porn, whatever you want to say. You're living in a dream. I'm just telling you. I am telling you as sure as I'm sitting here. I'm not trying to scare you. I'm trying to tell you truth. You got people that are distracted looking at other things out there. And that's fine. But what I'm telling you, like I said, my track record speaks for itself. Go back and look at my videos. I talked to you about the cube and the symbolism of it. We're going to touch on that a little more with Rihanna's new release of the cube that lets you know either they're following me or I'm telling you truth, because I told you about stuff a long time ago and now it's coming to pass. So unless they're all looking at Nicholson 1968's videos and say, you know what, we're going to come out with a video on the pulse and controlling people with tech, and then we're going to do a video with the cube, and you're going to see what I'm saying. Now, this is what I'm talking about. This was just released June 17th. I've been talking about cube symbolism, not only me, but other people as well out there. Calvin Harris and Rihanna just released a song, This Is What You Came For. As you can see, it starts off with the old TV bars when back in the day when TV was just beginning. But we're moving to the digital age more and more. Digital man becoming more digital, the mixing. If you haven't seen any of my videos in the past on the cube and cube symbolism, transhumanism, it is all part of a big agenda that mixing of iron and clay, digital reality mixing, it's all part of the digital world, the illusion that is coming. And in this video, as you can see, the cube, she is appears right in the cube with a blank white slate. There's nothing there. But as she starts going through the video, the crowd, the surroundings are all illusion. They're all digital inside the cube. And other people have good videos on this out there, but not just me. But this is symbolism of the illusions out there. They're telling you, it's right in our face. The cube. Notice that it is also the Lamborghini is shown here as well, and the symbolism of that. I mean, think about it. It just pops out of nowhere, a Lamborghini with this thing. There's nothing done by accident. And the Lamborghini and the logo behind it, the golden calf, the bull, speaks to Exodus 32, that it's the story when Moses went up on the mountain to get the Ten Commandments from God. He was delayed in coming back. The people down below could not wait any longer, so they decided, along with Aaron, to melt down the gold, earrings, everything they had, and they said to themselves, let's make us gods which shall go before us. So the symbolism of it, and this is what I'm talking about. The elites, the secret society, they take things that are beautiful and twist it and use it for their symbolism. Of course, the bull here, Lamborghini family, love bullfighting. That's where they came up with the bull. But in symbolism, this is what the elites do. They take that and use it, put it in things for a deeper meaning. Just like also the beautiful butterfly, which is used for monarch control. And they take something beautiful, twist it. You know, real quick on a side note, I know that most people that are watching this are very familiar with MK Ultra, monarch programming, mind control, but for you who are not, have never heard of it or don't even know what MK Ultra is about, MK Ultra monarch programming takes its name from the butterfly, the monarch in control, a monarchy, kind of what comes to mind. But anyway, MKUltra is a method of mind control that they use for a couple of different reasons. Some back in the day, and now to this day, it's not dead. Assassinations, mind control for sex slaves. You know, the reason for this project was named Monarch Program is because the victim undergoes a similar transformation than a monarch butterfly would. Like, it's a transformation from a caterpillar, then to the cocoon, which is the dormant state, inactive state, then to the butterfly, which is the new creation. The reason for the butterfly, most people are marked with a butterfly after the effect, or after the control is put into place. But thus the butterfly, when a person is undergoing trauma induced by the electroshock you, it's a feeling of lightheadedness, as if one is floating or, you know, fluttering like a little butterfly. You know, and at that point, the pain is so dramatic that it reaches, you have to disassociate, you have to disconnect from the pain, which you associate the lightheadedness, the butterfly effect. So that's what the whole MKUltra monarch programming and why the symbolism of the butterfly. They take something beautiful, twist it, and you have to learn the deeper meanings. Just like I've always said, red and black is symbolism for satanic control. And that doesn't make red a bad color, doesn't make black a red color. But when used to send a message and you learn that language, then you know what the red and black symbolism is. So everybody gets caught up, oh, this is evil. This, no, not necessarily. It's just how it's used when communicating through the symbolism of the language of these secret societies, how they use things like that. So, you know, just to finish up on the Rihanna video, as you can tell, watch this toward the end, she's asking you to come into this world, this digital world of the cube and what it represents. And say, and it just fades away to the cube and it goes off. So you can go to my website and you will see I've got a whole section of cube worship and what it stands for, what it means. It's on different levels. It's not just one thing. It represents illusion, represents also the transformation of human into a transhuman, the force within a human, the heart being taken out and put, something else being put in the place in the temple of God, the true temple of God, which is man, humanity, the deeper meanings. And I just wanted to touch on that. I don't want to go into a long drawn out thing with this video. I wanted to just make some other connections of these videos that are coming out, that are right in our face, that are telling you in symbolism. So we're going to move on now with Nicki Minaj and her album and some certain things, colors, some languages here. I want to set some things up. First off, pink is associated with MKUltra control. That's why you see Britney Spears, pink hair. Katy Perry, pink hair. Pink hair represents a Barbie doll or a doll, a plaything, something to be controlled. Pink is that reference. Also, she had her first album called Pink Friday. And we got to go deeper. Friday, the day of the week, is named after a goddess called Frigg, which has to do with childbirth. So you've got Pink Friday, right? So let's set this up in their language. Controlled childbirth. Everything that people who have followed me for years, transhumanism, the controlling of humanity, reproduction, those who know about the Georgia Guidestones, control reproduction. Pink Friday. It's that simple. So I wanted to set that up. So let's go to her first album, Pink Friday, and let's look at the tracks. Right off the bat, track 2, Romans Revenge. What did I tell you they believe in? A resurrected Holy Roman Empire, Romans Revenge. You got also you got track number 9, Blazing, Fire, Satanic. Track 10, Here I Am. There's only one I Am. The true creator is the I Am. So, Here I Am. We got track 11, Dear Old Nicki. It's not talking about Nicki Minaj here. It's talking about old Saint Nick, Santa Claus. Nicki, old Saint Nick. Santa Claus is a direct copy of the Creator. He sits on a throne. He loves children. He comes from the north. He can be omnipresent everywhere. Deliver all the presents in one night. I can go on and on. I have that information on my website as well of the worship of Santa. You know, Santa Claus, Saturn. It's all the same. It comes from Saturnella. You know, and here to that point, the next album she came out with, Pink Friday, Roman Reloaded. The first track is Roman Holiday. I mean, they're telling you in their tracks. Track three, I Am Your Leader. You know, who do you think she's talking about? Track number four, Bees in a Trap. Bees in a Trap. You're in a trap. Bees in a Trap. Track six, Roman Reloaded. Number seven, Champion. And these guys think that Lucifer, Satan, will be the champion at the end of the day. And that's the lie that they are being fed. You think that we are being lied to. The elites and the people high up are being lied to more of the deception because of their arrogance. And they think they have the ancient secrets and mysteries and all that stuff figured out. So let's skip on down to track 10, Starships. And in this video, Starships, that's where the cubes are shown as well. That is part of the future delusion coming. Most people, well, not all, I mean, but most people believe in aliens and that pre-programming. That's why it's very important to understand the story of the Nephilim and what they are about, because that is what's going on between the interdimensional beings back and forth. It is from the Nephilim and the Watchers. It is not aliens from another galaxy. That's part of it. That's why the church will probably fall away, starting to fall away even more in the future, because it has to do with God and the creation. And if he hasn't told us about aliens from another dimension, then that will cause the church to start falling away of all these, you know, aliens created us. We were, you know, produced here, hybridized, put on this, colonized on this planet, those things to come. So her next album that came out was Pink Print. Interesting titles on here. I'm going to skip all the way to the end. Track 16, Grand Piano. And understanding the constellations, there are 88 modern constellations in the sky, as above, so below, which on a checker or a chessboard in a Freemasonic lodge, it's an 8x8, is a chessboard, 8x8, again, the 88. Grand piano has 88 keys, black and white, the grand piano. So they're telling you who she is following here. Of course, track 12, Anaconda, Snake. No need to break that down. Track 14, Pills and Potions, Magic. Pills and Potions, Witch's Brew. Telling you some things here, what they're about. The track 8, Four-Door Aventador. Aventador, which is a form of Lamborghini. So, again, the Lamborghini reference here. We're going to get to track 1, All Things Go, which is Jay-Z, Do What Thou Wilt. Also, Aleister Crowley, too, as well. So track 2 is I Lied. Also, track 15 is Bed of Lies. So the father of lies is Satan himself. He is the father of lies. Track 10, By a Heart. Transhumanism. It's not the one you're born with. You buy a heart. I'm telling you some things coming. Track 4, Get on Your Knees. Bow down. Get down on your knees. So for those out there that are looking at this from another point of view, another set of eyes, telling you a different story. So this is mind control at its best. I've talked to you mostly about mind control of individuals, mind control of a mass. This is old technology that has been upgraded through the years that is at work here. And speaking of that technology, of course, I'm going to speak to Zern a little bit later, of the mind control, the messing with dimensions and things like that. But right now, I'm going to set some things up before we get there. You're looking at a group called Dream Theater, Rites of Passage. And let me just tell you, of all of the groups I have ever covered, Dream Theater is ahead of the curve. Whoever does their artwork, they know things. And what I'm telling you is on 9/11, let me show you this album cover. 9/11, this was released the day of 9/11, September 11th, 2001. Live scenes from New York. As you can see, it's right on the money. Live scenes from New York, Twin Towers in flames, Lady Liberty there on fire, the crown of thorns around the apple, mocking Christ. That was the original album cover, CD cover. They later changed it to this one right here. As you can see, their logo in it. And this is Dream Theater's logo now, and they say that their name is built into this, but let me just tell you what it is. It is 9/11 in Roman numerals, as you can see, 9/11, the 1XX1 built in to it. Also, the three pillars are there, Third Temple, three pillars, Freemason is built into it. Also, one with the big 00101. That's very significant. I did another documentary style video, the 101 series, The Deepest Story Ever Told Through Moving Pictures. You have to check that out. I'll share the link on that. But all of that is in this emblem. So they changed the CD cover to this one now. But it was released on 9/11. So you telling me that they didn't know something was coming on that day for it to be released. There's too many coincidences with this group and artwork, things that they write about. I mean, it is right on. So let me go back to Rites of Passage. Right off the bat, there's the sign of the Freemasonic Freemasons right there, the Masons, the square and the compass. And so, you know, they're telling you, let's just look what Rites of Passage means. Let's look up the actual definition of rites of passage. A rite of passage is a celebration of the passage which occurs when an individual leaves one group to enter another. Okay? Usually happens in three stages. First one, separation. Second, transition. Third, incorporation. Complete. The transition is complete. And what they're talking about is a lot of different things here. We're talking about dimensions, of leaving one dimension, entering another dimension, vice versa, and also becoming enlightened, becoming a 33rd degree Mason. You move from one step on up the ladder to another degree. It's multiple things that they're telling you. But also, here we go, speaking of Zern, this is also an alternate CD cover. A dramatic turn of events. The bridge, the doorway there, the opening, the portal. And the wings behind it. You see the wings there, you know, as far as angelic or whatever you want to say. They tell you things within their artwork. This one as well. He is branding a person with that emblem. And if you watch my videos, my about video, and that I have on my website that tells you how I got started, and that Roman numeral 1XX1 can be broken down. It actually can be broken down into the mark of the beast, and it is calculated to 666 as you break it down. It is built into the 9/11. I won't go into that here, but that was one of the first videos that got me started doing videos years and years ago. The original video is on my website, and along with another one that is not on YouTube. My first one, Do You Believe in Miracles or Magic, is on there, that YouTube will keeps taking down. So I put it up there, and hosted it on my website as well. So let's go through some of their album covers, and I may do a video just separately on Dream Theater, but here's, you're looking at one album cover, Dream Theater, Lie, with the all-seeing eye in the background, but also Time. Time is a lie. We're trapped in this time, this realm, for an age. It has to do with the cube and the illusion as well. So you've got that album cover. Then you've got, let's go to this one right here. Here we go, Order Out of Chaos, but their album cover, Systematic Chaos. Same thing. I mean, it's done on purpose. That's what I told you this year would start happening. The ramp up of shootings, just everything. It's crazy. So the next one is this one right here. This one's very interesting. Black Clouds and Silver Linings. It's got a doorway. Now what you're looking at, I'm gonna do it in the video. Look at what you're looking at here. Does this look familiar? It's just told another way. The Freemasonic tracing board, where you have the doorway up to the light. You've got the little, look at the Lucifer eye right there to the left on the easel. All-seeing eye. Doorway going up to the clouds, the way out. It's just a different piece of imagery telling you the same thing, just told a different way through artwork here. And also, Rites of Passage is one of the singles on this album. It's telling some stuff deeper. The latest one they came out with, this one's interesting, The Astonishing. And it has to do with technology, the all-seeing eye everywhere. They've got a video to it. One of the tracks is, track 7 is A Savior in the Square. And see, when you visualize that, most people say they're looking for a savior in the square, like in a square in the town hall. But when people who have followed me, I tell you about the Cube of Illusion, a savior in the square. That is exactly what they're talking about. They're not talking about someone standing out on the square on the corner. I'll probably do another video just for Dream Theater. Because this is, without a doubt, track 24, Begin Again, Heaven's Cove, Moment of Betrayal. It's Our New World. They are telling you, a hymn of a thousand voices, speaking of the hive mind, where humanity is going. They want everybody plugged in, one hive mind, hymn of a thousand voices, one of their tracks. So there's that one. Here's another one. Systematic Chaos, Special Edition. Repentance, Ministry of Lost Souls. In the Presence of Enemies. They're pretty much telling you Forsaken. You can say that I'm just stretching, but when you put everything together, it's telling you a bigger story here. This one's going to be interesting too. This one right here is a tunnel. Train of Thought with a tunnel. Tracks on it, This Dying Soul, As I Am, Vacant, In the Name of God, Stream of Consciousness, Endless Sacrifice, Honor Thy Father. So, you need to understand what these guys are telling you through their titles and their imagery, the all-seeing eye there in the tunnel. Now, speaking of tunnels, I'm going to switch gears here a little bit. And anybody remember, I did, and some other people did too, Lady Gaga announced that she was going to do the Grammy Awards with technology. And I'm going to play this little section for you right now. And then I'll be back. And I want you to see this because I put it out earlier, but I want to make some connections here. Right off the bat, cube worship, cube symbolism, and the cube and what it represents. If followers know exactly what that is that follow me. For you who don't, the cube is a representation of copying the Holy of Holies behind. In the Holy of Holies, there was a room, a perfect cubed area where God dwelt in the tabernacle of God. And I'm not going to explain it all here. You have to watch the videos that I've been shown to explain a little further in there and the cube symbolism and this cube worship all over the world, not just America, not just United Kingdom. It's all over the world, cube, and what it's about. And you'll notice in this the wording that is picked, seed of innovation. You'll hear her say seed of innovation. You also say, she will say, the mind behind the machine. I've been showing you since 1998 what that is. Who is the mind, the prince of the air, behind the machine? Also referred to as the wizard behind the curtain. Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. It's right there. It's right in your face. Listen to it. It is a message being told. The masses will not figure it out. You're fixing to figure it out with this video. I'll get started.
To launch the first of these experiences, we've collaborated with 6-time Grammy Award winner, putting the world's most innovative technology in the hands of one of the world's most innovative artists. But rather than me tell you, I thought we'd leave it to her to tell you about the work we've done together.
I have the potential to imagine the unimaginable. Think the unthinkable. With the arsenal of the world's leading technology at my fingertips, I now have the ability to invent the uninventable. Rebranding into its future, Intel has enlisted House of Thava to collaborate on a project that will showcase technology through creativity at the highest level. Our partnership will culminate in a performance that inspires to remind the world of the seed of innovation, the wizard behind the curtain, the mind behind the machine. Intel. Gaga.
So that was the commercial that we saw for the upcoming Grammy. So we're all awaiting Lady Gaga to do some kind of cube symbolism, this technology they're talking about, with the door opening, the hangar, all this stuff, okay? So, what happened, though, after that, David Bowie died, and they changed whatever they were going to do on the Grammys, they changed and did a tribute to David Bowie, but they still used the technology. Just hang with me a minute. I'm going to connect everything here. So, they had a ceremony they were going to do at the Grammys, but they changed it to the David Bowie, still using the technology of the face mapping. The technology Intel had. This is stuff that I showed in my Project Bluebeam video years ago. This right here, the mapping technology of the military. This has been around. What we're being shown, they've had this for decades. This is just being shown to the public just now. So, you know, that's what we got to see, was that technology. But remember this commercial that I played earlier. What has this got to do with anything? Which that's why I was telling you, things got changed. But let me tell you something. Watch very closely. I'm going to show this. When this, a doorway opens and there's numbers on the door. 5 and 6. 5 and 6. Right there. 5 and 6. What does that mean? Okay. So, I'm going to tell you what that means. And it's a reference to May 6th. What happened May 6th? Okay, I'll tell you what happened. You remember the Hoover Dam, May 6th through the 8th. The goat was projected on the Hoover Dam. Something is going to open up. I guarantee you, remember the goat? I'm just going to show you some of this. There was the goat projected on the Hoover Dam. Is also... was there was something else that was done over that length of time as well. And I'll show you this clip too. And I'll be right back.
Freightliner has worked just as hard on the autonomous driving technology as the people who once built this dam. Tonight, right here in America, we're introducing the world's first truck with an AV license plate. First autonomous truck on public roads ever, anywhere in the world. A vehicle to inspire our customers and the whole world, our Freightliner Inspiration Truck.
So in that commercial, you saw that technology of the on the Hoover Dam being projected, opening up just like a portal, a portal. What happens when a portal opens? Something is transported here, right? Okay, the truck on the top of the Hoover Dam, Infinite Inspirational unveiled. It is Freightliner. It is transporting stuff. And look at the signet at the end, the 8, Saturn reference. Something being transported here or coming out of one or the other or both ways. Now, you remember the goat on as the team is FC Colon, and that's a soccer team. Their mascot is Hennis. Guess what? Hennis the 8th. That's right, the 8th. There we go again with the 8, and it's a goat. Okay. Now it gets even crazier. I mean, this is how in-depth it is. You think that 5-6 was just some random day picked? No, it's not. Soccer ball, 5-6. What are you talking about, Nicholson? What are you talking about? I'll tell you what I'm talking about. 5-6. Number one, a soccer ball has 32, count them when you get a chance, 32 on a soccer ball. The 33rd would be the complete soccer ball. 32 different shapes on it, 33rd being the whole soccer ball. And it's also black and white, okay, Masonic. But here's what's even more crazy. There's only two designs on the ball. One is inside of a pentagram, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then the other shape, guess what? Hexagram, 6 sides, 5, 6. It is done on purpose. It is put in place. These numbers were picked for a reason, and the shapes that are chosen here are picked for a reason, deeper meaning. And I'll play a little clip from a great video. This came out years ago, Hidden in Plain Sight. I'll play part of that, and it'll explain it a little bit better. But it has to do with the microcosm and the macrocosm, or the large and versus the small. And let me interpret that for you. What it means is, in modern terms, what is trying to be attempted is to bring the spiritual into the material, and vice versa. The material and spiritual together as one. And I hope you understand what I just said, and why CERN and what it's trying to attempt to do. Bring something in from one realm and combine it. See, two things are going on at this point. There are people at CERN that they actually believe they're doing good things. They're trying to bring something in, look for something that they feel that we are missing, the God particle. That's what they believe. They believe that they're honestly doing a good thing. The other part is they're gonna open a doorway that we're not supposed to go through. That's the reality. That is what is going to ultimately happen. Time frame, I do not know. that is being worked on as we speak right now. You've got two things going on simultaneously. People that know exactly what's going on, trying to bring something into this realm that isn't supposed to be here. So just wanted to let you know that, of what CERN is really about. It has to do also with alchemy, and which, like I said, I'm going to play this clip, and then I'll come back, and you understand, I think, a little bit more of what is being shown here in symbolism and what is going to be attempted in the future, and things that are being set up right now, put into place to bring this about. And I'll be right back.
The pyramids at Dahshur hold keys to macrocosm and microcosm. First of all, the Red Pyramid isn't as steep as the Great Pyramid. Its face proportions match this red triangle within a pentagram. Tilting up four such triangles until they meet defines the pyramid and its slope. The pentagram is a powerful magical talisman that was a symbol of the Pythagorean school. The pentagram encodes the golden number phi within itself fractally. Phi is one of the most important numbers in mathematics, because nature uses it to proportion everything from pine cones to sunflowers and nautilus shells. Even our bodies are based on the golden section. The number 5 is associated with the microcosm, with life and in the growth of living things. The adjacent bent pyramid is the only pyramid with two slope angles. The lower slope is steeper than the Great Pyramid, and its face proportions match this blue triangle within a hexagon. Tilting up four such triangles until they meet defines the pyramid's lower slope. The upper slope matches the Red Pyramid, so it's red triangles within pentagons again here. So what's up with all the hexagons and pentagons? It has been said that the great enigma of alchemy is the mystery between macrocosm and microcosm. The word alchemy actually comes from al-chemi, which means the way of Egypt. I believe relating 6 to 5 is the essential key encoded at Dahshur. Renaissance master Albrecht Dürer made this drawing in his course in the Art of Measurement with compasses and a ruler. Everything emerges from the Vesica Pisces. Dürer's Melancholia I is one of the most studied pieces of esoteric art. Franz Dekwitz presented the following analysis in 1979 to John Michel, who published it in his 1988 book, The Dimensions of Paradise. The opening of the compasses is the key to the engraving's metrology. The compasses, sphere, measuring stick, and overall proportions all fit the same unit. As already mentioned, the engraving's proportions of 14 to 11 match the Great Pyramid's half-triangle proportion. The objects in the engraving are packed with hermetic symbolism, but the most interesting thing to me is the hidden controlling geometry. It's the alchemical wedding of pentagon and hexagon. Schwaller de Lubiks did this study of an Egyptian gateway. Notice the proportions of sixes and fives in the opening, and the octave height of 2 compared to the overall width of a fundamental 1. Henry Lincoln co-wrote Holy Blood, Holy Grail, which became an inspiration for Dan Brown's The Da Vinci Code, published more than 20 years later. In The Holy Place, Lincoln revealed what he calls a structured landscape in the former Cathar country surrounding the mysterious village of Rennes-le-Château. Again, we see the marriage of 6 and 5. The pentagram over the cube in DC is another representation of 6 and 5 coming together. Recall how triple sixes and fives are encoded in the Washington Monument as 6,660 inches equals 555 feet. America's monumental obelisk therefore expresses the relationship between macrocosm and microcosm.
So you know how in Cosmos, Carl Sagan talks about other dimensions, like beyond our world?
Yeah, sure. Theoretically.
Right, theoretically. So, theoretically, how do we travel there?
You guys have been thinking about Hugh Everett's many worlds interpretation, haven't you? Well, basically, there are parallel universes, just like our world, but just infinite variations of it.
You know the Veil of Shadows?
Echo of the material plane where necrotic and shadow magic...
Yeah, exactly. If that did exist, a place like the Veil of Shadows, how would we travel there, theoretically?
Well, picture an acrobat standing on a tightrope. Now, the tightrope is our dimension, and our dimension has rules. You can move forwards or backwards. But what if, right next to our acrobat, there is a flea? Now, the flea can also travel back and forth, just like the acrobat, right?
Right.
Yeah. Here's where things get really interesting. The flea can also travel this way, along the side of the rope. He can even go underneath the rope.
Upside down.
Exactly.
But we're not the flea, we're the acrobat.
In this metaphor, yes, we're the acrobat.
So we can't go upside down?
No.
Well, is there any way for the acrobat to get to the upside down?
Well, you'd have to create a massive amount of energy, more than humans are currently capable of creating, mind you, to open up some kind of tear in time and space. And then... you create a doorway.
Like a gate?
Sure, like a gate. But again, this is all...
theoretical. But what if this gate already existed?
Well, if it did, I think we'd know. It would disrupt gravity, the magnetic field, our environment. Heck, it might even swallow us up whole. Science is neat, but I'm afraid it's not very forgiving.
So there you have it in a nutshell. It's basically messing with things, technology, that we're not supposed to be messing with. So you have to ask yourself, where did this technology come from? This is part of the mystery. This is part of the conspiracy, is where did the technology come from? Did it come from the Nazis? No, you got to look deeper. You got to look way deeper than man. I'm going to share a scripture here with you. 1 Corinthians 6:3. Know ye not that we shall judge angels? How much more things that pertain to this life? There you go, folks. We're not going to judge good angels. We're going to judge bad angels. Fallen angels that created the Nephilim. This is why they do not want you figuring out. This is why the church has people scared. They do not want you figuring out Genesis 6:4 and the Nephilim. They do not want you to read parts of Enoch. They do not want you to read things of that nature. This is why it is falling apart. The veil is lifting. The lies of the Freemasons, NASA, the whole flat earth, spherical earth. Look, I've done research. I sat on the sidelines here. They don't want you knowing about trying to time travel and dimensions and what this reality is about here on Earth in this realm. The lies are coming undone. I'm going to leave at the end of this a little bonus video for you. I hope you enjoy it. But I'm officially coming out, and I'm going to tell you, I've done prayer, done research. Do I believe the earth is flat? Do I believe it is round? I tell you what I do know. From doing all of my research, all of the information out there now, I believe this is an enclosed, flat, domed system. That it is enclosed for protection. That, and I know you're saying out there, oh no, Nicholson's like, no, do your research. Just like 9/11. When we first came out and I told you about 9/11 and other people told you too about 9/11, and that you thought we were crazy. And now look where we're at. Same thing with information on transhumanism. Same information I've given you on programmable matter. DNA tampering, genetics, put it all together. We will judge the fallen angels. And why do we get to judge fallen angels? Because they messed up this realm. They're the ones who taught us war. This is where the technology comes from. This is how you learned about abortion. This came from the fallen. We get to judge in the end. Humans do, folks. This is what it's about. You're not going to hear it in your local church. And they don't want you hearing it. That's why it's left alone. So you need to figure out why the light. So here's my thing. Let's go back to the flat earth. Everything that I do, I look at from this point of view. If the flat earth, why would there be, why are they lying? What's in it for the elite? Why would they tell us that there's planets and multiple galaxies versus it really being just us, an enclosed system and a creator above us, above the firmament? Do you see where this is going? Look at it from that standpoint. Get the anger out of the way and look at it from a Christian perspective or a human perspective. Why would the Freemasons the elites, the secret societies, be lying about the Earth not being enclosed or a flat system, because it makes you doubt. That's where the alien deception is coming. It's not aliens. It's Nephilim Watcher offspring messing in and out of the dimensions here. And we're helping. The people we're helping don't know they're helping. That's where I'm coming from. That's why for a long time I didn't want to really consider the flat Earth thing, but because I always question what is in it for them. What is the benefit of the lie? They get multiple $1 million sent to them. NASA, all of that. That gets sent and they do whatever they want and do the projects that they want. The hoaxes, everything. You look at it. Do your research. Don't just dismiss it. And I'm not here to convince you. You do your own research. I'm not going to go into depth and all. There's so much information out there now on it that people do it very well professionally and presented. But again, don't come off angry and just take a time out for a minute and think, why would they be lying? And what's in it for them? A lot is in it for them. So thank you guys for watching. I'm going to leave you with a bonus video that I made. I took a group called Korn, video Coming Undone, which you see their album cover here, with the doorway, the reference to Alice in Wonderland, the doorway opening, the keys coming in, the bear, teddy bear, which is the light bearer, reference to Lucifer there, coming into this realm. The lead singer with his Celt, his Masonic Freemason Celt, telling you some truth in this video, is the backdrop to this video. But I'm going to share little things here. I'm going to do it Nicholson 1968 style from way back. So I'll give you a little of both worlds here. But please enjoy. And again, thanks for watching.
Okay, Phoebe, this is it. In this briefcase, I carry actual scientific facts. A briefcase of facts, if you will. Some of these fossils are over 200 million years old.
Okay, look, before you even start, I'm not denying evolution, okay? I'm just saying that it's one of the possibilities.
It's the only possibility, Phoebe.
Okay, Ross, could you just open your mind like this much? Okay. Now, wasn't there a time when the brightest minds in the world believed that the Earth was flat? And up until, like, what, 50 years ago, you all thought the atom was the smallest thing until you split it open and this, like, whole mess of crap came out. Now, are you telling me that you are so unbelievably arrogant that you can't admit that there's a teeny tiny possibility that you could be wrong about this?
There might be.
Choke, choke again. I thought my demons were my friends. Pity me in the end, they're out to get me. Since I was young, I've tasted sorrow on my tongue. And this sweet sugar gun does not protect me.